Krista Wade here with Let's Wade In. So glad you could join us today. I have a friend who is a really great teacher, and every year parents and students were on waiting lists to get into her class. And on the first day of class, do you know what she said? She said this to all those students who had waited to get into her class. She said, "I am very mean. And this is what you will do. You will do this, 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 and this. And if you do it, you will get stars or stickers, whatever it was. And at the end of the week, these good things will happen. And if you do not, then you will lose stickers or stamps. And at the end of the week, this is what will happen." And the students were shocked. They're like, "Oh no, we've gotten into the class of a mean teacher." But do you know what? From day one, my friend, the teacher, had set her expectations very clearly, so all the students would know what was expected, and the classroom was safe, and it had boundaries and expectations, and the students knew what they needed to do from day one. And at the end of the year, those students were crying and hugging her because they did not want to leave her class because she wasn't mean. She was a good teacher, and she loved all of her students dearly, and they loved her too. But she expected them to meet certain requirements, and she told them that at the beginning very clearly. Do you know that your world-class coach, your Heavenly Father, has expectations that He has outlined for us in Scripture very clearly too? He is not mean, just like my friend. He has just outlined them very clearly. And when we develop that relationship with Him, and when we learn to train in the ways that He has laid out clearly for us in His Word, then our life opens up and good things are flowing to us. And that's what we want for you. One of the good things is in Proverbs, let me see here, Proverbs 16:7, and it says, "When a man's ways are pleasing to the Lord, He makes even his enemies live at peace with Him." In our world today, there are many dangers, many different things from all angles, and with enemies. And these are not frenemies. These are real enemies. And if we are following the expectations that our Father, who's a world-class coach, laid out for us in His Word, then He makes even our enemies live at peace with us. So this is very important. This is something that most adults don't even know. Now, we'll get to some of those things in a moment, maybe in the next video. But right now, I want you to remember Abraham. Do you remember Abraham? He is called the father of the faith, and he lived in the time that there was a lot of tents, a lot of traveling. Even though he was living in tents with his cattle and sheep, and he was really more of a camp. There were 300 people with him, and his sheep and his cattle and donkeys and all that, which sounds like a lot compared to a few people living in a home like we do today, but it was still a small family camp because there were nations all around Abraham, nations with buildings and cities and military. So that's kind of scary. Abraham is camping in the middle of nations that don't really care for him, don't really want to see him succeed. And his number one thing that he's doing is he's developing his relationship with the world-class coach, who is Abraham's Heavenly Father and yours. And as he was doing that, the Father kept His word. And what he did was made Abraham's enemies, which were nations with military around him, live at peace with him. In fact, one of them even came and said, "Abraham, would you please promise not to hurt us?" Okay, here's a nation with cities and people and money and military, and they are coming to Abraham, who is a family in a camp, and saying, please don't hurt us. Okay? Because God made Abraham's enemies live at peace with him. And you can read about this in Genesis 14 and 21. It is a true story. And he will make your enemies live at peace with you. And let me tell you, that is a sense of peace that many adults in our world have no clue about. They do not understand that if they would adjust things in their lives to do what the Father expects, just like the students in my friend's class, then the Father would do for them what they're wanting, which is to make safety, to make their enemies live at peace with them. Okay? So there are many good gifts that the Father has for you, good gifts and promises, when you follow the expectations that he's laid out in his word and you spend time with him. As you go with God, go for the gold in the race of your own life.